Now, many of us know of him, but there are several things we don't know about him. Hey friends, it's Brittany Valadez, and in this video, I'm gonna share with you facts that you may or may not know about the Apostle Paul. Now, over the past several months, I've been doing tons of research on the Apostle Paul, and I pretty much know everything except his DNA. There's a new movie out right now called Paul, Apostle of Christ, that I encourage you to check out. All right, let's get started. He grew up in a well-to-do family. He was from the tribe of Benjamin and was named after Israel's first king, Saul. Many of us believe that his name change from Saul to Paul came after his conversion, but that's not actually the case. Now, his Hebrew name was Saul, meaning asked for, while his Roman name was Paulos, meaning little. He was well-versed in Jewish law. At that time, young Jewish boys would learn the scriptures beginning at the age of 5, and by the time they were 10, they would start learning Jewish law. He studied under the famed rabbi, Rabbi Gamaliel. I probably definitely pronounced that wrong. Now, Paul, even though he was Jewish, was actually a Roman citizen by birth. Now, one time in Jerusalem, he was arrested, and he used this towards his advantage. Paul was about to be flogged, but before he could be flogged, he pointed out that it's against Roman law to flog a Roman citizen who had not been convicted of a crime. Actually, it turned out he wasn't even supposed to be in shackles. Pretty wise thinking, Paul. Now, when it came to his stature, he was actually small in size. He was small and appeared to be feeble and actually had a bald head. Now, in the Bible, he and his traveling ministry partner, Barnabas, were on their way to Lystra. When they came to Lystra, the people assumed that Barnabas was actually the god Zeus and that Paul was his messenger. Now, obviously, none of them were false Greek gods, but that kind of can show you that maybe Paul was actually smaller in person. He is believed to have been single all his life, never marrying, and of course, never being a widower. Paul has some sort of sickness or injury that he wanted healing for, and he often prayed to receive it, but he never did receive it in his life. Now, he never asked for money for his preachings, but did encourage other believers to help out churches who weren't so financially stable. He also never preached against preachers receiving compensation. He actually said it was okay. He couldn't stand these people called Judaizers. Now, Judaizers were those who claimed to be Christian, but preached the false gospel of a works-based faith. Now, you and I who are believers know that when it comes to Christianity, it's just believing that Jesus Christ died and rose again that will get us into heaven. It's not who can be better than the other or how many good deeds you can do this week. Because if you think about it, we'd be working towards that all our lives and we would never actually reach the level of good enough. The books of the Bible that were written by Paul were actually letters to churches and some of his fellow preachers, which would be like Timothy, which is one of his friends. Now, Paul wrote 13 of those books, possibly 14 if you believe he also wrote Hebrews, but that's sort of up in the air. There's 27 books in the New Testament, which shows you that Paul pretty much wrote half of the New Testament. Now, Paul's longest letter was to the Romans. This is unique because this was a church that he did not start himself. If you look at the book of Romans, there's 19 chapters. He could speak Hebrew, Aramaic, and Greek. If you were well-versed and smart, you were speaking Greek. See? He could reach the highest of the high and the everyday person like you and me. Paul was responsible for bringing the gospel to the Gentiles, which means anyone who wasn't Jewish. He believed that he was specifically called for this purpose by Jesus Christ himself, which he was. Now, while on the road to Damascus, Paul experienced his famous conversion. I will list where you can find that in the scriptures below. Actually, if you look in my description box, you will find several things that I may not listed in the video in the description box, like references, things like that. Now, what's interesting about Paul's road to Damascus was he was actually going to find more Christians to persecute. He had this obsession with finding them and capturing them and then persecuting them. Now, oftentimes, many of us assume that Paul hated God, but that's actually not the case. Paul thought that he was doing a service to God by going out and capturing these people who were going against Jewish teaching. Obviously, it wasn't until his conversion that he figured out what he was doing was really wrong and stopped killing people. Now, on Paul's road to Damascus, the Lord appeared to him through a voice and a bright light. Now, some people think there's contradictions in the Bible when it comes to this, but actually, there's not. Paul was the only one out of those around him who could hear the words of Christ. Everyone else could probably obviously see the light or maybe hear a sound, but Paul was the only one that could hear the Lord's words. Paul's capture by the Jews was foretold by the prophet Agabus in Acts 21, but he still went anyways. He knew what he was doing was for the Lord, and when he was there, he was actually able to witness to his captors. Now, while in prison in Rome the first time, Paul wrote what we call the prison epistles. These are Philemon, Colossians, Ephesians, and Philippians. Now, the second time he was in prison in Rome, he wrote 2 Timothy. It is believed that he was arrested in AD 67 and was ordered by Nero to be beheaded, according to tradition. This is where the movie Paul the Apostle of Christ begins, towards the end of his life. Now, after my studies on Paul's life, I've come to learn several important things, and probably the most important one is to keep the faith. We have maybe 70 to 100 years on this life, if we can even reach that. But that's just a speck, like a molecule, the smallest thing you can think of compared to the eternity that we have with Jesus Christ. When we keep our focus heavenward, we're able to get through this life by following the will of the Lord. Hope you all like this video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe. Leave a comment in the section below if you found something interesting that I mentioned in this video, or maybe there was something that I didn't mention that you know about the Apostle Paul. Until next time, I'm Brittany Valdez, and I'll see you later.
It will be a very beautiful, emotionally very moving film with a rather wonderful ending. And redemption is offered and is clear.